Today we are discussed about the experiment number 2. The experiment number 2 subtopic is use different types of electrical or electronics tools. Myself, Mr. Vaswadi Yogesh, lecturer from Electrical Department, SIT Polytechnic, etc. First is practical significance. While performing the electrical wiring or maintenance work, everybody should be aware of the proper tools required. Unavailability or not using proper tool may be lead to improper quality work and may lead to an accident or injury. The practical significance explains that when we working in electrical field or maintenance work, then we should be aware about the proper electrical tools which are well insulated and safe in condition so that we can perform our task safely without any type of unavailability of tools which are create a faulty work and maybe sometime it is injurious to our health. Okay, therefore we can perform using the specific tools. Second point is relevant program outcomes. There are mainly three types of program outcomes for this experiment. First is discipline knowledge. Apply electrical engineering knowledge to solve a broad-based electrical engineering related problem. In this point, explain we solve the electrical engineering related problem by using the specific tools which are used in electrical engineering so that we can perform well activity or electrical maintenance to apply the breakdown of electrical engineering machines or materials. Second point is experiments and practice, in which plan to perform experiments and practice to use the result to solve broad-based electrical engineering problems. That means we can solve our electrical engineering related problem, that means we can performing the safe electrical engineering practices so that we can use electrical safety tools. Next is the engineering tools. Apply relevant electrical technology and tools with an understanding of the limitations. That means when we performing the electrical activity, then we can use advanced tools or electronics meter so that we can solve the breakdown problems or maintenance work or any type of installation easily. Next point is competency and practical skill. This practical is expected to develop the following skill for the industry identified competency. That means plan wiring or cabling activity using relevant material following safe practices. We can improve our technical skill by using the various types of advanced electrical engineering tools so that we can perform safe practice or safe activities. Identify various electrical and electronics tools. In this practical, we can identify various types of electrical hand tools, power tools or electronics meters, multimeters, etc. Use various electrical and electronics tools. We can use here various types of power tools, hand tools and their applications. Following safety practices while working with tools, we can perform or doing safe work with advanced tools so that it will be not damage our health or physical damage of our body, and also it is not damaged that particular tools so that we create or follow the safety practices. Relevant course outcomes. Following safe practices when undertaking electrical work, we can follow safe practices with advanced tools so that we can perform safely electrical engineering problems or or installation works. Practical outcomes. So the practical outcome of this experiment is use different types of electrical and electronics tools. We can use different types of electronics and electrical tools in this experiment. This is the outcome of our experiment. Relevant affective domain related outcomes. Practice good housekeeping with safety measures. Demonstrate working as a leader or a team leader. Maintain tools and equipment and follow the ethical practices. Relevant affective domain, which is related to the proper housekeeping with safety equipments, that means safety tools. Demonstrate the working of safety equipments as a team leader or as a member of a team leader. Maintain the tool in good condition or maintain the tool or equipment in proper working condition. Next is follow the ethical practices. That means we can follow the use of safe practice of electrical or electronics tools. Next point is minimum theoretical background, in which electrical technicians kit is very simple and brief. Here we can use the electrical, in this diagram shows the electrical safety tool kit in which various types of electrical hand tools and power tools are given. Same types of measuring instrument also given, that means ammeter, voltmeter, etc. The main tools in the kit are plier and screwdriver, which are plier is used for the to grip the job, to cutting of wires, cables, cutting of wires and various types of insulation removing or twisting of the wire joints. And screwdriver is used for the to tighten or loosening the screw. The electrical technician can do much work only with these two tools. In electrical field, these two tools, that means plier and screwdriver, is mainly important because major electrical work can be performed by using these two tools. But for electrical wiring purpose, it is required a special kit consist of tools such as cutter, scratch anvil, tri-square, hacksaw, hammer, drilling machine, test lamp, tester, soldering iron and desoldering iron. For electrical wiring purpose, we can use the various types of tools, that means cutter for cutting the wires, scratch anvil, tri-square, scratch anvil, it is also known as the poker, which are used to marking on the object. Tri-square is used to check and mark right angle in construction work. Hacksaw is used to cutting the PVC pipe or iron conduit, etc. Hammer is used for the forging. Drilling machine is used for the to drill on the object. Test lamp is used for to check the supply availability. Tester is used for the to check the availability of phase wire. Soldering iron is used to soldering the electronic components, wires, etc. And desoldering is used for the desoldering the soldering metal. Next is practical setup or circuit diagram or work situation. Here we cannot use the circuit diagram because here only we use the various types of electronic or electrical tools, hand tools, power tools or measuring tools, which are used in electrical work. Next is types of electrical tools, in which various types of electrical tools mainly we are used, in which hand tools, it is used in electrical and maintenance work, which do not require any type of electrical powers. We can perform various types of activity with help of this type of tools. Cutter, plier, nose plier, hacksaw, hammer. These are the examples of hand tools. Next is the power tools. Power tools which required electrical supply to operate. various types of activities in which drill machine, blower, hacksaw machine, etc. are included. Next is the measuring tools. Measuring tools is used to measure the electrical parameters, that means electrical current, voltage, power, resistance, capacitance, inductance, etc., which are included in the measuring tools. These are electrical tools which are used in case of electrical maintenance work, breakdown work, electrical installation work, etc. Next is resources required. Here we can use the electronic toolkit, which is standard nature. It is quantity required, 1 kit. Steel rule, which is used to measure the distance of or measure the length of various types of hand tools which are available in specification of hand tools. Next is the precaution to be followed. While doing this practical, we can some follow the precautions which are related to the electrical safety. First is use ISI mark tools. That means we cannot use the any type of local tools so that we can injure from these tools. Second is use proper tools for proper work. That means we cannot use the plier for twisting the or tightening or losing the nut bolts, etc. These are the example of relevant tools. Next is the never carry pointed tools in pocket. That means pointed tools means poker. Poker is a pointed tools which are used to marking on the wall or any object or sometime to drill the wall, which do not carry in the pocket. Never use damaged or broken tools. We can never use the damaged or broken tools. That means if we work on the live wire, then without insulation equipment we are do not use them. When we are this type of equipment used, then it will be harmful to our body. Next is the procedure. In practical or experiment procedure, we can identify various types of electrical and electronic tools in which we observe the given tools, that means pliers, screwdriver, and their use. We can observe the how screwdriver will be identified, or cutter, or combination plier. There are many types of plier, that means side cutting plier, chainsaw plier, chain lock plier, combination plier, long nose plier, etc. We can differentiate between them and differentiate between their applications. Draw the freehand sketch of given tools. It is required to draw the freehand sketch because due to we drawing the freehand sketch, we observe the every point which is related to the equipment. Next, label the different parts with drawing, measure and observe and note down the size of tools and specification. We can note down the size of tools and specification in observation table. Observe the make of tool and note down the different applications of given tools. Repeat the above instruction for other tools. That means we can repeat the every procedure according to the screwdriver. That means we can observe the identification of screwdriver, their size, their specification. We draw the specific tool diagram or to identify the tools types or differentiate between the various types of tools, etc. This procedure we can follow at the time of practical. Use various electrical and electronics tools. Collect old and broken switchboards, electronic circuit. Remove the electrical accessories, electronic equipment. Use proper tools. Teacher should be guide student as per the use the various types of electrical tools to use or how to use in electrical maintenance work. We can perform the various types of activities which are related to the applications of hand tools, power tools or measuring tools. Follow the safety practices while working with the tools. Follow the instruction given by the teacher while working with electrical or electronics tools. Write safety precaution in your own words or any two tools. Here we write down the various types of resources which are used in case of working with the tools. Which tools we are used, write down the here, and here write down the actual procedure we can follow. Next, in observation and calculation, use blank sheet provided if space is not sufficient. In observation, we can observe the how to identify the tools, name of tools, freehand sketch of tools. Here we draw the freehand sketch of tools. Next is their size, that means their length, specification, their type, their main specification of tools, which type of make or which company made these tools. Here write down the name of make or company name. Application, what is the application of these specific tools and what precaution which will be followed, write down here. Here number 2, number 3, number 4. Four sketch will be draw here. Here name of tools, freehand sketch, size, that means length, specification of tools, make of tools, application of tools and precaution which would be follow. Write down here and draw the sketch here. Now we see the various types of tools. This is various types of tools in which first one is cutter, second one is stripper, insulation remover cum cutter. It is side cutting plier, it is long nose plier, it is also stripper, but it is automatic type stripper. It is manual and it is automatic type stripper. It is combination plier. Next is crimper, which is used to crimping of lugs. Next is gripper, which is used to grip the object. Next is channel lock plier or monkey plier, which is used to tighten or loosen the screw. Next is pipe spanner. Pipe spanner is used to holding the or gripping the big object, tighten or loosen the big screw, nut bolts. There are various types of screwdriver. This is tester, flat type screwdriver, star shape or cross shape screwdriver. This is adjustable screwdriver in which both flat type and cross type screwdriver are inserted in handle. Next is screwdriver set. It is ball pin type hammer, which is used to forging on object. Next is chisel. It is used to slot on the wall at the time of concealed wiring. Next is punch, which is used to punching the object at the time of drilling. Next is measuring tape, which is used to measuring the distance in inches or centimeter. Next is hacksaw. Small hacksaw is used to cutting off PVC pipe or casing caping. It is various types of files, in which first one is flat type file, second one is half round type file, and last one is round shape file, which is used to plane the surface. It is spirit level, which indicates the how surface is parallel to the earth or perpendicular to the earth. It is various types of spanners, ring spanner, flat spanners. Next is power tools, in which drill machine, wood cutting machine, grinder. It is wood cutting machine or slotting machine, which is used to slot the switchboard. It is a drilling machine, which is used to drilling on wall. This is various types of drills which are used in case of electrical installation or electrical wiring. Next is grinder. Grinder is used to plane the surface or to remove the extra part. Next is measuring instrument, in which we will already seen measuring tape. Next is wire gauge. Which is used to diameter and distance of wire, diameter and gauge of wire. Next is voltmeter, ammeters. Voltmeter measures the voltage of the supply, and ammeter measures the current through the load. It is meter, which is used to measure the insulation resistance. This is both type of multimeters, which is measure the, it is digital type multimeters, which is measure the voltage, current, frequency, etc. So it is called as multimeter because it perform different or multi activities. That means measuring voltage, current, resistance, capacitance, etc. Now, first hand tools is combination plier, which is used to gripping the object, twisting the object, and cutting the object. This is jaw, which grip the object. It is made from mild steel or high grade steel. It is used to cutting of wire conductors, twisting of wires. Making the joints of electrical conductors. It is insulated condition because sometime we are working with the live conductors or live situation, so that insulation is provided on the handle of the plier. It is also remove the insulation of wires. Next is the side cutting plier. Side cutting plier mainly used for the cutting of thick conductors. That means for overhead line conductors. It is available in 6 inch, 8 inch or 10 inch. This is side cutting edge. Next is long nose plier. Long nose plier mainly used for the to hold the object or grip the object of in small areas. It is also made from the high grade steel. It is also insulated. It is also used to cutting of wires, to tightening or loosening the small screws. For small applications, it is used. It is also insulated. Next is channel lock plier, which is adjustable in nature. So it is used to tightening or loosening the object. Next is locking plier, which is used to grip the object tightly. Both are used in combination. It is made from the high carbon steel or stainless steel. Next is the cutter cum insulation remover. It is manual cutter. It is jaw, which is used to remove the insulation, and this is cutting edge, which is used to cut the wires, small type of wires. See here, we cut the wire by this cutting edge, and for insulation removing, this type of jaw is used. We can remove the insulation easily by using cutter cum insulation remover. It is automatic wire stripper. It is manual wire stripper. In manual wire stripper, it is possibility to cut the conductor at the time of insulation remover. But in case of automatic stripper, size will be given so that we can remove the insulation easily, or किती अंतरापर्यंत इन्सुलेशन आपल्याला रिमूव्ह करायचं आहे ते सुद्धा या मेजरिंग मापावरून कळू शकते आपल्याला. या ठिकाणी किती इन्सुलेशन आपल्याला रिमूव्ह करायचं आहे एक्झॅक्टली, आणि असा ॲडव्हान्टेज म्हणजे यामध्ये कोणत्याही टाईपचे कंडक्टर कटिंग होत नाही, फक्त इन्सुलेशन रिमूव्ह केलं जातं. त्यानुसार आपल्याला इथं ॲडजस्ट ते करता येते, कटिंग एज किती ॲडजस्ट करायचं आहे, किती इन्सुलेशन आपल्याला रिमूव्ह करायचं, त्यानुसार हे ॲडजस्ट करता येतं आपल्याला. It is also used to cutting of wires. Here is cutting edge is given, so we can cut the wires. This is both wire stripper. Next is the screwdriver. Screwdriver is mainly used to tightening or loosening the screws. It is available in 6 inch, 10 inch and 12 inch. It has also for electrical work, insulation is provided on the blade. Previous is flat type screwdriver or slot type screwdriver, because the blade of screwdriver is flat, so it is called as flat type screwdriver. And next is cross type screwdriver. It is cross type screwdriver or star screwdriver. Flat screwdriver is used to tighten or loosening the flat screw, and star type or cross type screwdriver is used to tightening or loosening the star type screw or cross type screw, which is mainly used in electronic equipments. This is handle, which is insulated, and blade is also insulated so that we can handle it safely at the time of working of electrical installation. Next is screwdriver set. It has only one handle and number of blades. Star type, cross type, or flat type. Or sometimes it is auger is also provided on the set. The blade is inserted on this jaw. And we can tighten the nut and it is hold the strip. It is Allen key screwdriver in which hexagonal type screwdriver and bolt is available or nut is available, in which we can insert a Allen key which is L type of shape. We can easily remove, tighten or loosen the screw or nut or bolt. This type of nut bolts used for special application where loose gripping is required. Next is tester. Tester is used to test the phase wire or test the phase terminal. It is made from metallic blade, one resistance which is approximately 3 kilo ohm. After that, one neon lamp, spring connector, and last is metallic nut. Metallic bolt, sorry. It is a 3-pin plug. Now we check the tester. In which this is earthing. One is neutral and one is phase terminal. This lamp is not glown, so that supplies phase is not available here. In earthing is also not phase available, but in terminal light is glow or bright, so that we can understand this is the phase terminal or live terminal. Okay, light will be glow or neon lamp will be glow at phase terminal. Next is continuity tester. Continuity tester mainly used for the to check the continuity of the equipment. This is switch. When we on the switch, then two terminals are connected to each other internally. So the continuity tester lamp will be glow. See here, this continuity tester made from the cell, one neon lamp and connectors in which current is passing through the this object, so that we can find out the wire or object is electrically continued or electrically continued present or not present in this object. Now we check the MCB. MCB switched on so that connection will be created. When MCB is off, then disconnect the switch. MCB will be not glown. Now we check the wire continuity. where wire is open circuited or closed circuited. See here, the wire is continually not cut anywhere, so that the electrical current passing through the wire and electrically this wire is electrically closed, so that the lamp will be glown. Testing lamp is used to check the supply availability. This is phase wire and this is neutral wire. Continuity tester, फक्त या वायरची कंटिन्युटी किंवा कुठल्या ऑब्जेक्टची कंटिन्युटी आहे का नाही, तो कंडक्टर सलग आहे का नाही किंवा कुठे कट झालेला आहे, ओपन झालेला आहे, हे चेक करण्यासाठी आपण कंटिन्युटी टेस्टर यूज करतो. जर वायर कट झाली असेल तर हा लॅम्प लागणार नाही आहे. जर वायर चांगली असेल, कट कुठेही कट झालेली नसेल, क्लोज सर्किट असेल, तर हा लॅम्प ऑन होणार. जर वायर कट झाली असेल तर हा लॅम्प ऑन होणार नाही. म्हणजे कोणत्याही ऑब्जेक्टची कंटिन्युटी चेक करण्यासाठी, इलेक्ट्रिकल कंटिन्युटी चेक करण्यासाठी आपण या कंटिन्युटी टेस्टरचा यूज करतो. Okay. Next is the test lamp. Test lamp is used to check the availability of supply. Supply is available on that installation or not. If lamp is glow, then supply is available. Otherwise, supply is not available. Next is standard wire gauge. Standard wire gauge is used to measure the conductor gauge or conductor diameter. It is used to or used at the motor winding section to measure the conductor wire size. This type of measuring is done by this person. त्याच्यावरती डायमीटर पण लिहिलेला असतो आणि गेज पण लिहिलेला असतो. जे गेज आणि डायमीटर हे दोन्ही इन्व्हर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल आहेत एकमेकांच्या. नेक्स्ट इज क्रिम्पिंग टूल. क्रिम्पिंग टूल इज यूज्ड टू क्रिम्प द लग्ज ऑन द वायर्स. वी यूज्ड लग्ज to proper connection of the terminal with the wire. If we twist the wire around the screw of or terminal of the motors, then it will be loose connection. When we pull the wire, then it easily removed from the screw, so that we can use lugs. Before that, we remove the insulation as per our requirement or as per the size of lugs. After removing insulation, we insert the lugs into this conductor. And now we crimp the lugs. इन प्रॉपर जॉब आता यामध्ये काय करावं लागेल, क्रिम्पिंग ज्या वेळेस टूल घेतो आपण, त्या क्रिम्पिंग टूलमध्ये ज्या साईजचा लग्ज असेल त्या साईजमध्ये आपल्याला तो लग्ज असेल तो इन्सर्ट करायला पाहिजे. मोठा पण घेऊन उपयोग नाही. ज्या साईजचा सपोज 4 square mm लग्ज असेल तर 4 square mm जॉबमध्येच आपल्याला या ठिकाणी लग्ज तो इन्सर्ट करावा लागेल. 4 square mm वायर असेल तर 4 square mm लग्ज आणि 4 square mm जॉज यूज करायचा आहे. लहान मोठे जॉ यूज करायला नाही, अदरवाईज ते कनेक्शन लूज होऊन जाईल किंवा तो लग्ज आहे तो तुटून जाण्याची शक्यता असते. त्यामुळे प्रॉपर साईजच यूज करायची. 4 square mm वायर असेल 4 square mm लग्ज असणार आणि 4 square mm जॉ यूज करायचा आहे आणि त्याला प्रेस करायचं आहे. प्रेस केलं की ते क्रिम्पिंग तुम्हाला दिसू शकेल या ठिकाणी. तेव्हा त्याने क्रिंप केलेला आहे, क्रिंप केल्यानंतर पूर्णपणे प्रेस करायचं, प्रेस केल्यानंतर ते सोडून द्यायचं. ते सोडून दिल्यानंतर काय होणार, अलगच त्या ठिकाणी क्रिंप झालेला आहे. या ठिकाणी ॲडजस्टेबल की असते या ठिकाणी एक, येते बघा तो लग्ज व्यवस्थित क्रिंप झालेला आहे. आपण कितीतरी वायर ओढली तरीसुद्धा ती वायर त्या लग्जमधून निसटणार नाही, म्हणजे प्रॉपर कनेक्शन होऊ शकते. त्या नटामध्ये आपण असा लग्ज इन्सर्ट करायचा. त्या वेरियस टाईप्स ऑफ लग्ज असतात, एक आहे तो रिंग टाईप, आहे तो यू शेप टाईप, एक आहे तो पिन टाईप. या ठिकाणी लॉकिंग क्ले असते, जोपर्यंत मी पूर्ण प्रेस करत नाही तोपर्यंत हे बाहेर येत नाही, म्हणजे ओपन होत नाही. ज्यावेळी तुम्ही पूर्ण प्रेस करशिला हँडल, त्याच वेळेला इथं ओपन होणार आहे. जर अर्धवट प्रेस केला तर हे ओपन होत नाही. या ठिकाणी लॉक की असते, त्या लॉक कीमुळं लॉक होऊन जाते. नेक्स्ट इज हॅमर. हॅमर इज यूज टू फोर्ज द ऑब्जेक्ट, म्हणजेच हॅमर आपण आघात करण्यासाठी यूज करतो. त्यामध्ये वेरियस टाईप्स ऑफ हॅमर आर अवेलेबल, बॉलपेन हॅमर, क्रॉसपेन हॅमर, मॅलेट एटसेट्रा. दिस इज द फेस अँड दिस इज द बॉल पिन विच इज यूज्ड इन इलेक्ट्रिकल फील्ड टू इम्पॅक्ट ऑन द स्क्रूज ॲट द टाईम ऑफ वायरिंग. दिस इज क्रॉस पिन हॅमर. इट इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड ॲट द टाईम ऑफ वायरिंग टू इम्पॅक्ट ऑन द स्क्रू. This type of hammer is used to remove the nails from the object. This is handle which is made from the wooden or ebonite material which is insulated, which is and long handle is gives the higher grip and higher strength on the object to forge the material. This is mallet is used to give shape the winding. At the time of winding we are used a mallet to give shape the winding. Both edge are ebonite type or plastic material. Next is electrician knife. Electrician knife is used to remove the insulation of large size of wires. Wire cutter only used to remove the insulation of one conductor or single conductor, but in case of cables we are used a electrician knife to remove the insulation from the wire. Next is hacksaw. Hacksaw is used to cut the PVC pipe. Here we insert the hacksaw blade and tighten by this screw. एक स्क्रू टाईट केल्यानंतर ह्याच्यावरचं जो टेन्शन आहे ते मिडियम साईजमध्ये पाहिजे. जास्त टाईट पण नको आणि जास्त लूज पण नको पाहिजे. इज यूज्ड टू कटिंग ऑफ मेटल ऑब्जेक्ट और पी वी सी पाईप और कॉन्क्रीट पाईप इन इलेक्ट्रिकल फील्ड. Next is spirit level. It is automatic types or different type spirit level which is used to check where the surface is perpendicular to the earth or plane to the earth. Next is soldering iron. Soldering iron which is used to solder the two conductors. It is element inserted here. Element when supply is given to the soldering iron, then element will be heated and it heated the tip of the soldering iron which is melting the soldering wire. This solder will be melt on the joints in electronic equipment. In electronic equipment mainly we are used this type of soldering. Every PCB it has various electronic component placed and it is jointed by soldering gun which is soldered on the PCB. Next is the poker. Poker is used to mark the or mark on the object, or sometime it is used to or used as a drill to drill on the wall. Mainly now it is used to only for the marking. Event we have studied the different types of electrical tools in which various types of hand tools, power tools and measuring tools we are studied. Now student should be draw the sketch of any type of equipment or hand tools and sketch in which plier or screwdriver, hammer, tester, poker, soldering iron, etc. The name of the tools write down here, please sketch, size, specification you can write down by search on the internet or by using the lectures. Next is you can write result, interpretation of result and conclusion at your own language and solve this question by using the lectures or by using the internet. You can search the answer of questions. Okay, our today's experiment is over. Thank you.